clapper. That's the corn clappers. Ta-ta. There are a lot of reasons to make this recipe. This is an excellent corn chowder. We have to start with corn. Corn these days is incredibly sweet. It has been bred to be super sweet. There used to be all kinds of varieties of corn being grown all over the ding-dang place, and they had like more nuanced, corny flavor with other flavors in it. That's one of the things that we have to adjust for in the corn chowder is to balance out some of that sweetness. There's a lot of different ways on the internet that people are gonna tell you to take the kernels off the corn, and I've tried them all. One of the ways that I like is cut off a little strip, then that gives you like a flat, right? I just made a little base. And then you're just zipping the corn kernels off and then roll it onto that side you just made and zip them down again. And you wanna just make sure that you're going deep enough to get to the base of the kernel, right where it meets the cob. I'm gonna use the kernels, I'm gonna saute them, and that's gonna be like part of the flavor base of the soup, but the cobs is really what I'm after. We're gonna make a corn broth. Here's our 8 ears of corn, kernels removed. This is a couple of Parmesan rinds. Why am I putting Parmesan rinds in a corn broth? They're salty, they're umami. They're also gonna give the broth body. Shiitakes. We're gonna have mushrooms in the saute that's part of the vegetable mix. The stems have a lot of flavor. Bay leaf, which Adam Rappaport doesn't believe in.
If you made this without the bay leaf, you would never know.
But I do, and so does the rest of the Bon Appetit Test Kitchen. Fresh thyme. And then salt. Most stocks are not gonna tell you to add salt, because if you make a stock or a broth that then gets reduced, that's already been salted, all of that salt magnifies and gets too salty. But because the way that we're gonna use this, we're gonna use the stock without really boiling it down, that salt is just gonna make this more rich and more flavorful. All right, let's go to the stove, because we also need water. And this is 8 cups. It should be enough to just cover everybody. And you can already see that the water looks a little bit milky right away. That's the cob itself has this like that delicious, all the juices from the corn. I'm gonna bring it up to a boil. And then once it's at a boil, I'm lowering the temperature, medium low. I want this at a gentle simmer. That's gonna take about 45 minutes. At this point, you are gonna be like, I could have made a whole chowder in 45 minutes. You could, but it won't have all of these layers of flavor. And you're gonna build so much flavor into the cooking liquid itself that when it combines with the other ingredients, they don't have to cook together for very long, because everybody is bringing a lot of developed flavor already to the party. Flavor and time are kind of like, you know, connected. So all of this is to make the corn more delicious and to show it off. I am chopping mushrooms for the chowder, which is gonna be part of the vegetable medley mix that goes in before we add the cream. Now we go back over here and we saute some stuff. The first thing I'm gonna do is salt the corn, add pepper. My stock is simmering, if anybody was curious. Okay, so this has to saute until the corn is bright yellow and starting to be tender, and then I'll deglaze it with the white wine. What we're balancing throughout this whole recipe is the overwhelming sweetness and starchiness of corn. So I've been a Bon Appetit, guys, like coming up on 8 years. So I've had a hand in like pretty much every recipe we've published since then. And so when I was looking at this recipe, I can remember the conversations with Rick. And I can remember him telling me why everything was important. And then I can remember him being like, okay, I made it this way, and then I made it that way. And we would taste both versions. And it was true. Like, the version where you do a little bit more is more delicious. Okay, so it's been 12 to 15 minutes. And what's going on in the pan now is that some of the corn juices that came out of the corn and the butter itself are kind of browning on the bottom of the pot. I'm gonna take out half a cup of this mixture, and we're gonna use that for garnishing later. And now I'm going to deglaze with that 1/4 cup of white wine. And you'll hear it bubble up right away. I just wanna cook it enough until the wine evaporates and the juices left in the pan are thickened and a little bit syrupy. All right, so I've got my corn for my topper whopper, and I've got my corn for the chowder. So now we're gonna build the chowder with the other ingredients. A little more butter. And then we have bacon. If you want to keep this vegetarian, obviously don't put the bacon in. You might need another tablespoon of butter, though, to make up for the fat that the bacon is rendering. I feel like we are approaching golden brown if fat is rendered. Look at that fat. I mean, come on. Shallots are going in. We have some grated garlic. I got some beautiful leeks. Potatoes that have been beautifully diced. And then I've got my shiitakes. So the goal right now is to get everybody softened. I'm not looking for a lot of color on the vegetables. I just want to get them to where they're starting to sweat. Kind of like me on the subway in the morning, just a pale sheen of sweat starting to warm up, but I haven't like gone toasty yet. I'm straining the stock, P.S. Talk about a light sheen. Oh yeah, I'm getting the parmy flavor and I'm getting the herby flavor. I taste the bay leaf very strongly. Tell Adam Rappaport that. This is very balanced. This is, Rick, cheers. So I have a couple of fresh red chilies. If you don't like heat, don't use the chilies. We are specifically say to remove the seeds, so that decreases things quite a bit in the heat department. I don't know, I actually want a little heat. Gonna leave some of the seeds in. Also, a lot of the heat is in the ribs. It's not just in the seeds itself, but the ribs. Oh, she's hot. Okay, never mind. I'm gonna take the seeds out. Yeah, my lady's hot. That's hot. That was spicy. I feel great now. I have a late sheen. I'm gonna take my very hot chilies that I chopped, a little bit of flour, and our delicious corn stock. We're gonna move on to final stages. So the veggies that I wanted softened, but not taking on color. I think we are there, but everything looks really good. So now I'm gonna add those chilies. They don't take very long. I just want them to kind of soften and start to bloom. This is all-purpose flour. The reason the flour is going in is because it's gonna add body to the broth. And then I'm gonna add my delicious corn broth. And when this goes in, it's gonna loosen up anything that was stuck to the bottom of the pan. And a wooden spoon is really good for scraping the bottom of the pot because all of that is very delicious, concentrated little flavor bombs. That's what I like about cooking. A lot of feedback. Getting a lot of feedback off the end of this wooden spoon. Oh, we're very close. But I do want everybody to mingle now. The vegetable flavors are gonna go into the broth and vice versa. And we need to cook off some of that flour. So this is gonna look a little bit thicker in a couple of minutes. The key with herbs is not cutting them too many times. The thing you don't wanna do when you're chopping herbs is chop them and then turn them and chop them again and then chop them some more and then turn them the other way and then rock your knife back over them again and then pile them back up again and chop them again. That's when you bruise them, they turn black, they get all sludgy, they lose their integrity. Don't think about it as chopping herbs. Think about it as slicing the herbs. Oyster crackers, these are for serving. Marjoram, actually gonna go into the soup. The cream of the chowder. This is it, finish line. Heavy cream, 2 cups. Marjoram, the corn's gonna go back in. Everybody's gonna party, let's do it. Ready? Freaking Molly Baz over there. Stay tuned for whatever that story's gonna end up in. Secret. So instead of adding a lot of cream, like twice as much cream earlier and reducing it or cooking it all through here where it's like coming down, it's that amount of cream, but it's also got the delicious broth and it's gonna cook for a very short amount of time from this point forward. That's that beautiful sauteed corn mixture that I made earlier. Some of my vegetables got a little brown on the bottom of the pot. Hey guys, this is why we say in the recipe, it's like, don't let it take on color. That is why I talked about it. It was like, oh, it'll make it a little bit brown in the end. I did that. Then I made it a little bit brown and it was a little bit stuck on. You don't throw it out. You don't stop going. You keep going.
Ma, the chowder's gonna be brown.
Ma, why'd you make the brown chowder? Still pretty. Buddy, calm down. The marjoram smells delicious. Marjoram is like a more floral. I love it too. I'm bringing it back.
Yeah. wanted to go away.
Marjoram is like, what, a more fragrant, a little bit more aromatic oregano? Yeah.
And it's softer. It's similar, but it's definitely more tender than oregano. And it doesn't have the kind of spice you get.
Totally, of oregano. Verified by the what are you? The herb slayer. All right, I added salt because it needed it. I'm really happy with the body and the texture of the soup. I'm very happy with the flavor. I think there's the right amount of liquid. I'm turning it off. I'm adding controversial marjoram. Oh, now look what's happening to this color story. Gorge. Okay. This is like mom music's chowder factory. Gonna spoon it up. What I like about this soup right now, I gotta tell you, the proportion of the brothy bits to the vegetable and bacony bits is very ideal. You know how sometimes when you're spooning it up and it's like too thin or too chunky? It's just right. And then I really do like little oyster crackers. Those are adorbs. Okie dokie. Oh, look who's here.
Oh, hello. Why is it this deep, dark color?
I'm so glad you asked.
Wait, can I guess?
The first person who comes to taste it is like, why is the chowder brown?
Well, it kind of looks like almost like lobster bisque. Like it's going in a bisque world, which is not far off from a chowder. So.
To me, it's also like late summer when there's starting to be some dust in the air and like the wheat plants are
the
like.
Dust is in the soup.
No, it's just like
delicious.
Really delicious.
I can't believe there's mushrooms in here. I feel like that's.
I like that.
You make a corn. Yeah. There's
good.
A corn stalk
and
that
has good chili.
Depth. Yeah, the fresh chili for sure.
Yum. I like the little heat from the chili.
Mm-hmm.
I'm into it. Breakfast of champions.
Of the chowders of my youth, but like just much tastier and less like gloppy, gloopy, gummy. Just like the grown up version of what I used to eat.
Rick, everything you made us do is worth it.
Miss you, Rick. Love
in the market.
It's a chowder. It's a power chowder. You know what I mean? It's not like a, it's on purpose. It's purposely chowdery.
Don't hate it.
Don't hate it at all.
It's a good chowder. You should make it.
Mm-hmm.
Cooking bacon is an easy way to get the people that you love to show up in your kitchen.
Dude, what are you cooking?
Oh, bro, I smell bacon.